Hi there. In this video, we will be talking about the famous egg dropping problem. So let's begin. The problem statement. We have k number of eggs and a building with n floors. What is the least number of egg droppings that is guaranteed to find the highest floor from which the egg won't break on dropping? Okay, let's just take out the important info here. We have k eggs, a building with n floors. Now with those k eggs, we are supposed to find out the minimum number of attempts which will guarantee us to find the highest floor from which the egg won't break on dropping to the ground. Let's go ahead and understand more elaborately. Okay, so we have this building with 9 floors here and we have 3 eggs. So in our case, we have 3 eggs to drop from a building of 9 floors and we have to find out the highest floor from which the egg will not break. So what do we do here? One way is to just take this one egg and drop it from each floor starting at the bottom. The floor from which the egg breaks is the floor we were looking for. But that won't take the minimum number of attempts because we still have 2 eggs left that we can use to minimize the attempts to find the right floor. But what if we had only 1 egg? Well, in that case, we won't have any other choice. We would simply take it and drop it from each floor starting at the bottom. Now, let's say the floor from which the egg breaks was this, the 5th one. The egg drops and breaks. The number of attempts it took was 5. But if we had only 1 egg, would 5 be the minimum number of attempts which guarantee us to find the floor from which the egg breaks in any different case? No. Instead, the correct answer would be 9. 9 is the minimum number of attempts which will work for any case. Nine attempts with a single egg will guarantee us to find the highest floor in any 9 floor building. Now let's come back to the original problem. We have 9 floors and 3 eggs to work with. So to solve this, let us assume a function eggDrop. Now let's assume that this eggDrop function returns the minimum number of attempts needed to find the high enough floor from which the egg breaks. And in our case, we have 9 floors and 3 eggs. So let's replace the variables here with that. Consider this first egg. Now we don't know which floor we should choose to drop this first egg from so that we can use the next 2 eggs to minimize our attempts to find the required floor. So we will simply consider every case. That is, we will consider dropping the egg from every floor and choose the case which returns the minimum attempts. Now, for any floor, let's take 6th floor, there will be 2 cases. Case 1, the egg breaks. Case 2, the egg doesn't break. With the first case, which is when the egg breaks. If the egg breaks, then that means the floor from which the egg will first break will lie below the 6th floor or is this floor itself. Now, if the required floor is this floor itself, then we got it covered as we will find it within the minimum number of attempts. Otherwise, we just look at the lower part of the building. This seems like the same problem as the original one, but this time we have 5 floors and 2 eggs. So the corresponding function call for this subproblem will be eggDrop 5, 2. Now this function will return the minimum number of attempts needed for its corresponding case, which is 5 floors and 2 eggs. Similarly, for the second case, we will be looking at the upper part of the building and the corresponding function call will be eggDrop 3, 3. Okay, now for any floor, there will be 2 such cases and they will be written in similar fashion. So there's one thing to bring to attention here. From any floor, we need to cover both cases, that is, both possibilities, the egg breaking as well as the egg not breaking. Although only one of these possibilities will occur, so out of the values that both of these functions will return, we will choose the one which will cover both cases and that value will be the bigger one of these two. Let me explain a little bit more. Keep in mind, these functions are giving us the minimum number of attempts. So if we have any more attempts than the minimum required, we can still work with that. So here, whichever part, the upper or the lower, needs more attempts will be prioritized as the other part can still be covered with the greater number of attempts chosen. Coming back to the original problem, this is the function call for the top floor, which is the 9th floor. Since there are 8 floors remaining at bottom, the parameters for the first function are 8,2, and there are no floors on the top, so the second function is xDrop 0,3. In a similar manner, we will consider each floor and write their corresponding functions. Now, since dropping egg from a floor should count as one attempt, we will simply add 1 to each expression. Here, we have all the cases considered of dropping the first egg. For 9 floors, there are 9 expressions, each of which covers both the possibilities that we discussed. Now we need to choose the case which will return the minimum number of attempts. So we do exactly that. And thus, the original problem, that is, egg drop of 9,3, can be expressed in terms of all these cases as shown. Please note, each of these cases will cover the whole building. That is, each of these cases represents the minimum number of attempts needed to find the required floor if the first egg had been dropped from their corresponding floor. Now, if we generalize this process, it will be easy to implement while coding. So let's do that. So here's what the basic function looks like. Egg drop of n, k. N is the number of floors, k number of eggs. Now for the n floors, we'll consider each floor and write the subproblem functions corresponding to it. For the top floor, it will be 1 plus maximum of egg drop n minus 1, k minus 1, comma egg drop 0, k. Here, egg drop n minus 1, k minus 1 represents case 1, that is, when the egg breaks. We look at the bottom floors only. Egg drop 0, k similarly represents case 2, that is, when the egg doesn't break. We look at the top floors, and since there are no floors at the top, this will return 0. Similarly, for each floor, we do the same thing until we reach the bottom, where we get 1 plus maximum of egg drop 0, k minus 1, comma egg drop n minus 1, k. And our main function will return the minimum of all these values. All of these will keep recursively calling their subproblems until there are no eggs or no more floors to consider. That is the base cases. Another base case will be when we have only one egg left. In that case, the value returned will be equal to the number of floors itself, as with one egg, we will need to drop it from each floor starting from the bottom. Now, let us do some optimizations. For understanding, we have simplified the representation of the egg drop function here with e, k, n, where k is the number of eggs and n is number of floors. The parameters are swapped, so do not get confused. Let's take this example of 2 eggs and 4 floors. Now, as we have been doing all along, there will be 2 cases corresponding to each floor. 4 floors in this example. So, these are the cases for each floor. We have not written all of them as we just need to focus on these. For n equal to 1, which is the bottom floor, e 1,0 represents the case 1, which is when the egg breaks. So we have one egg left, and since there are no floors below the bottom floor, the number of floors is 0. Similarly, e of 2,3 represents the case 2, and so on. Expanding this partial recursion tree further, here, if we observe closely, there are some repeated function calls, and this will cause the same problems to be solved again and again, which is not a good thing. So to overcome this, we'll simply save the solution of these smaller problems in a 2D array. I said 2D array because we have only 2 parameters. So corresponding to the parameters, the solutions will be saved at the corresponding locations in the 2D array, where rows represent number of eggs and columns represent number of floors.
So this is it for the explanation part. Now let's jump to the code. So here's the code. You can find it in the article link below. Let's look at the implementation now. So first of all, we are considering all of our base cases here. That is, when there are no floors or there's only one floor left, the attempts needed will be 0 and 1 respectively. And another base case is when we have only one egg left, then we will simply return the number of floors for that particular case. So let's come to the main part of this. Here with this loop, we are iterating over each floor and then covering both the cases for that floor. These are the function calls for the cases. And with this res variable, we are simply taking out the minimum from the values corresponding to all floors. Alright, so this is just used to take out the minimum of all those expressions that we discussed about earlier in the explanation part. Finally, we are returning this minimum value with one added to it because throwing an egg should be counted as an attempt. So simple as that. Now let's go to the other implementation of the code. Now to overcome overlapping subproblems, we are taking a 2D array to save the solutions and retrieve them whenever needed. So the method to do that is same here. Since we have all of our base cases filled up, we'll use them to solve in a kind of bottom up fashion. So here in this first for loop, we are iterating over the number of eggs, and in the second one, which is nested inside, we are iterating over the number of floors. So this will basically take all the combinations for the egg drop function in account. For example, we are starting with 2, 2, as the first loop starts with I equals 2, which represents the number of eggs, and the second one, the nested one, starts with J equals 2. So to solve the egg drop 2, 2 here, we'll do the exact same thing that we have been doing all along. Alright, we'll solve both cases for each floor and then find the minimum of them. Alright, so we'll do that with this third loop over here inside this second loop. Okay, so now the important part. Why we are solving egg drop 2, 2 is, as we have our base cases filled up, the only values needed to determine the value of egg drop 2, 2 are those base cases, are the values corresponding to those base cases. Okay, observe this. For egg drop 2, 2, if we look at the bottom floor, there'll be two cases, right? And the first case when the egg breaks would be egg drop 1, 0, because there are no floors at the bottom and we have only one egg left. And when the egg doesn't break, it'll be egg drop 2, 1. So both of these cases are base cases, so they're acting as smaller subproblems for this particular problem. And when we get this value determined for egg drop 2, 2, this will act as a smaller subproblem to the rest of the bigger cases. Alright, so this is how the complete table will be filled up in a kind of bottom-up fashion. If you want to, you can like draw a 2D array on something like paper and just observe how the values are being filled and how the locations are being translated inside that 2D array. It'll give you a better overview of what's going on. So that's all guys, thank you for watching. If you liked this tutorial, don't forget to show your appreciation by liking and leaving a comment. And for more such videos, don't forget to subscribe.